Well, more than ever, we're being advised to look at our diet, what we eat, and our sugar intake. Now, sugar is just one crop of nine that account for 66% of food production worldwide. Now, think of the resources that uses up. So can we find some sort of replacement for sugar? Well, my two guests here think they may very well have done that. With me is Carsten Petri, co-founder of Legria, and Mary Olwal, who also is a co-founder. So welcome to the two of you. Mary, why is it so essential we find some sort of substitution for sugar?
As you just mentioned, we have a lot of sugar in our diet today, and it's no secret. Everybody knows that we have about 1.9 billion adults who are obese or overweight today, and we have to do something. And that's why it's essential that we change our diet and make it more nutritious. It's just not that people are obese, it also costs a lot of money from a taxpayer point of view, because all these other diseases, cardiovascular diseases and diabetes and so on and so forth, are putting a big strain on the spending, healthcare spending, for example.
So Carsten, how did you guys come up with the idea of this sugar substitute, if you will, and how does it work? Where does it come from?
Well, actually, the idea came out of a Bühler internal innovation process. And we were actually looking for a way how to use the resources in a better way. And we found the brewer's spent grain as a very good source, which nowadays is like a rather waste or a side stream, which is only used for animal feed. And we thought it's a very interesting product which should be used for human nutrition as well. So our idea was to upcycle this with an innovative technology and make a sugar replacement out of it.
So this is something that before was either going to waste or was used for animal feed.
Exactly. And now we can use it, for example, in biscuits, in hazelnut spreads and cakes to reduce sugar and at the same time add valuable fibers and proteins to the food.
It seems a great idea. Have you met any resistance from manufacturers or sectors of industry to putting this into their food products?
I wouldn't say we've met resistance. Actually, if you look at all the consumer trends, there's this health and wellness trend. People want to know what they're eating. People want a healthy diet. And people also, at the same time, want to be healthy within the limits of the planet. So we address these two issues of the sustainable use of natural resources for healthy food. So I must say we are getting a lot of interest with the food industry, who many companies and many partners who are interested in Legria. But I must say it's a slow process to get such an ingredient to consumers, and that's where we are at the moment. So we are trying to get that momentum and to get really the first product on the shelf.
So you've proved that it works then, have you? You're mm-hmm. satisfied with that. It's just a question of marketing now, is that it?
Exactly.
Okay. And why the name Legria? What does it mean?
Legria means delightful. It comes out of, a word out of the fourth Swiss language, the Retro-Romanian language. So we thought it would be nice to have a name which shows it's a connection to Switzerland, since we are Swiss-based. And we think it's a nice word. As I said, it means delightful pleasure, and that fits very well with our product.
Great. Well, of course, the two of you used to work for Bühler, and now you're in a startup supported by Bühler. Can you outline for me, Mary, exactly how Bühler helps or what support you get?
Oh, it's tremendous what we get from Bühler. I mean, we are at home here in the Quebec, just from a point of view that every day hundreds of customers walk by, Bühler customers who are potential Legria customers, is an enormous help to us. And you said we are former Bühler employees, so we have a huge network within Bühler. And when we're proving our concept, for example, and trying to make new products or develop recipes which we can showcase to our potential customers, we can use all the Bühler facilities, all the application centers, not just in the Quebec or in Oatsville, but worldwide. So at our booth, we have cookies from Copenhagen and field pillows from Wien and Vienna and everywhere else in the world. So that's the application side. And also on the technology side, we are using Bühler technology to produce Legria.
And is it important that the two of you buy into the Bühler philosophy of reducing waste and energy and water in food production by 50%?
Absolutely. I mean, that's our main motivation, actually, from the beginning on. So we were, from the beginning on, searching for something that fits with the Bühler strategy and the Bühler targets. And we achieved this by making a food ingredient in a more sustainable manner, in a natural manner, and also to produce something which is nutritious, and that way also contribute to a healthier diet.
See, I think this is quite important because the two of you could have a business idea and Bühler could back it as a purely a business idea. But this is more than that for you guys. This is a philosophy almost, isn't it?
It is for both of us. It is a philosophy and also for Bühler. I mean, where we came from, as Carsten said, we came out of a micro MBA program within Bühler. And the idea we were supposed to come up with was to fit within the Bühler values and strategy, and that's why waste reduction or alternative use for side streams and health completely fits in the innovation for a better world policy.
And in getting there, what have been the main stumbling blocks? What problems have you had to get over?
As Mary said, we got a lot of support internally, but it was also clear that we cannot develop this alone, for example, so we needed a collaboration partner. And so that was something we were searching at the beginning, and thanks to the great network of Bühler, we found a perfect collaboration partner to do this. And we think with all the challenges we see in the world today, we cannot do it alone. And collaboration is important, so collaboration was one important thing. And then, of course, I think like all the startups, they're facing the problem of scaling up. So you have an idea, you can produce on a very small scale. And now we're at a point where we want to set up a bigger production. And that's a challenge, but we accepted that challenge. And I think we're on a very good way to be able to produce Legria on an industrial scale very soon.
And if I'm somebody who makes a living out of providing sugarcane at the moment, do I look on you as the enemy or an ally in the long run?
I will say more than an ally, a friend. Because, we cannot do away with sugar completely out of our diet. I mean, we need sugar for energy, the right amount for it. And secondly, sugar has many other functionalities in making food other than just the sweetness. So we can't do away with sugar completely, but we have to use less of it. So if you're producing sugar cane and thus industrial sugar, then you need me as a friend so that you can cover this market need that's there. So you can provide your sugar, but at the same time provide healthy alternatives that can be used in combination with the sugar. So could be good friends.
Good. All right. Final question, if I may, to you, Carsten. What will be success for Legria? When will you look back and say, we got there, we did it? And what will that success consist of?
Apart from the financial success, which is obviously coming first, I would be very happy if people in a few years come to me and tell me they like Legria, and they think it's a great ingredient, tasty ingredient, and that it made their diet healthier. That they use it in a huge variety of products. So that, for me, that would be a huge compliment if I would hear that.
I wish you both the very best of luck, Carsten and Mary. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.